Atmana, the rahasya, the secret of Shaivism, in the beginning of Kali Yuga, Puram Asan Mahatmanam Rishinam Vaktur Kohre. The secret of Shaivism was residing in their heart. They would explain it without writing it. They didn't write theory of Shaivism at all. It was in their brain. They would explain it, bas. And it would penetrate those to whom it was explained. And they were the same. They became the same. And there is another shloka of how great is Lord Shiva. Dhyayet nityam mahesham rajat girinibham charu chandavatam sam. Dhyayet, you should concentrate. Dhyayet nityam, you should concentrate nityam, always. When you are likely to meditate and when you are not meditating, when you are sleeping, when you are snoring, when you are walking, when you are talking, nityam means that. Always you should, yes, dhyayet, you should concentrate on that. Mahesham, who is the Lord of Lords. Lord of Lords is Mahesham. And he is Rajata Girinibham. He is so big. You can't imagine how big he is. His body is so big, he is just like, say, the mount, big mount of silver, white silver. Big mount of white silver, it is his body. From Kalagni Rudra to Shandatita Kala. He is so big. What can ordinary people do before him? They are nothing. And you should recite that. Jayet Nityam Mahesham Rajat Girinibham. And Charu Chandravatasam. And Charu means very beautiful. Chandra means the Chandrakala. Is Avatamsam. It is on his forehead. It is decorated on his forehead. And that Chandrama is called Mahi Chandrama, objective world. All objective world. Whatever is existing, whatever is not existing, that is objective world. This whole objective world is Chandra. And he has put that on his forehead. It is his avatams crown, just like crown. So he has accepted this whole universe as his own crown. So it is not separable. It is not separated from his being. Dhyayet nityam mahesham rajat girinibham charu chandravatamsam ratna kalpo jalangam ujjalangam. His body is ujjal, shining, glittering. His this white body, just like this body, it is glittering with sparks from that shining from white. You know sparks? Sparkling all around. Like this. Rajita Girinibham Charu Chandravatam Sam Ratna Kalpo Jalangam. And all ratnas, all jewelry is shining, is producing. From that body. You should think of Lord Shiva like this. Rajna kalpo jalangam parashu mrigavara bhite hastam trinidhi. And in hand, he has got parashu. Parashu means hatchet. Hatchet is for those who are sinners, cut them into two, finish them all together. Parashu, mriga. And he has got mriga. Mriga means temptation. He has created temptation also for those to just see if they are tempted or not, or remain in their own position. But some don't remain in their own position, they are temptation. He has created temptation also in this world. That is mrig. That is, mrig is temptation. Mrig is that deer. Deer is very beautiful.
Huh?
Just like Sita. Because Sita was tempted. And this temptation was just trial in which she didn't succeed. She was tempted. So temptation should not be accepted. In Yoga Darshana also it is said, Sthani Upanimandrane Sang Sumyakarnam Punaranishta Prasangat. If one goes in Samadhi, a perfect Samadhi, and all gods and goddesses come before him, pay their respects before him, and offer him, this you have obtained by your Samadhi, please accept this offering, please accept our offering, please accept Sangha Sumya Karnam. One should think at that time, no, I won't accept it. It is only temptation. I should not have this. You should remain in that consciousness of Lord Shiva. If he does not do that, Praranishtha Prasangat, he will fall again. So this is test for him. From that test, he must come out.
What kind of things do the gods and goddesses offer them?
This is jhana. This is beautiful plane. It needs no petrol. You can fly anywhere in this world. You have obtained it by samadhi. You should not accept it. I can go by thought only. Why should I accept this kind of machinery? Punaranishtha Prasanga, he'll fall again in this world. Jayas Nityam Mahesham Rajati Girinivam Charu Chandra Avatamsam Ratna Kalpo Jalangam Parashum Ragavara Bhiti Hastam Trinetram. He has got three eyes. One is objective, and one is subjective, and one is cognitive. This whole cognitive world, this whole objective world, and this whole subjective world are his three eyes. They are not separated from each other. Object, subject, and cognition are same. Lord Shiva is residing equally in these. Object is not inferior. And subject to consciousness is not superior. They are in the same level. In that supreme God consciousness, where I reside. Understand? What have I explained?
Objective, subjective, and cognitive being the same.
Yes. Trinetram. Mahesham Rajita Girinivam Charu Chandravatam Samratnakal Pojjalangam Parashum Ragavara Bhiti Hastam Padmasinam. He is Padmasinam. He is in Padma. Padmasinam means he is lotus. He is seated in lotus. Lotus from below, and lotus above from this way. He is residing in that lotus. One lotus is Kalagni Rudra and another lotus is Shatajita Kala. He is there seated. One lotus is from above. How great is he? What can these demons then do before him? Padmasinam samanta stutam amarganai. Samanta stutam amarganai. All those who are immortals means gods, goddesses, Indra, Shiva, Narayana, all those, Tutama Maraganai, all they pray these songs of this great being, Parabhairava. Samanta Astutam Amaraganai, Padmasinam Samanta Astutam Amaraganai, Vyagrikritim Vasanam. Vyagrikritim Vasanam, he has loincloth of Vyagra. Vyagra means this lion skin, petticoat. He has got petticoat of lion skin. It means he is lion of lion. Nobody can tolerate that. And you know the body, the measurement of that body, the measurement of the body of Lord Shiva is from Kalagni Rudra to Shandachita Kala. So great. What is America and what is Srinagar and what is there? It is all there. It's nothing. And this is the definition of Lord Shiva's form, which is formless. Bas?
So what is the meaning of Shivaratri?
Shivaratri is very inferior.
Yeah, what is the importance of that? In terms of Lord Shiva,
Ratri, Iva Ratri. It is white night. It is not dark night. Shivaratri means, Shiva means white. Ratri means night. It is that night which is bright night. It is white night. It is not dark night. It is not black night. Shivaratri means white night, where there is glamour, where there is light. Actually, at night you feel darkness. It is not Shivaratri, it is not that. Shivaratri is where it is, this night is white, brilliant, glittering. All things are visible. There is no need of torch, there is no need of lamps, bulbs. On voltage lamps, or whatever, you can try. It is more than that. And in other words, it is Shivaratri. Shivaratri means that night where you are graced with Shaktipata, our Lord Shiva. In that night, he bestows Shaktipata. He was Tir Shaktipata is bestowed to that who deserves. So this is today's lecture, right?